Greetings and welcome to another edition of Traditional Draft, Kaladesh Remastered on the Magic the Gathering Arena. So the pack one, pick one is going to be the Scrouncher, I think. The commons don't have anything that great in here. I think the Dawn Feather Eagle is the best common in here, but the uncommons has a long task cub and the scrappy scrounger, which are both very good cards. And I think out of these two options, I think I picked the rare. I mean, I think it's close, but I like the black card slightly more than the green card here. So here we have a rare has been taken. So Thopter Arrest is of course very good card, and then what we have here is the underhanded designs. Well, I mean, this can kill a creature if you have a lot of artifacts in the deck. Out of these options, I think I'd still rather pick the Thopter Arrest, because well, this requires a lot of artifacts. I know my first pick was an artifact and a black card. It would work nicely with this, but this I think still is something. I mean, it requires you to have quite a few artifacts in the deck, and this just doesn't really ask nothing much. It's a solid removal spell, and I think it's a somewhat easy pick in here. I mean, 3 mana, get rid of an creature or an artifact. I mean, it can't really be that bad. It has to be I know it is a good card. It doesn't require anything from your deck. It's just a good 3 mana card. Removes everything. But here we have interesting choice. I think it's gonna be the Vengeful Rebel, and I'm gonna pass these underhanded designs again. I mean, I know I have passed two of these, but I think this Vengeful Rebel is a good enough card that I can pass this. Yeah, I mean, of course I need some kind of ways to trigger or activate the revolt. Like, I mean, of course I can activate it by just attacking and having creatures trade with each other, but I would rather have some more reliable way to trigger this. But I can pick one, especially in here. I mean, I could pick the Swooper here, which is good. Of course, this Nature's Way is good too, but I have no green cards, I have no blue cards. I could take the Implement of Malice. I could also pick this one of these off-color cards, but maybe I just take the artifact right now. Not sure if it was the right pick, but I just wanted to kind of synergize with the cards I already have picked in here. And it's actually quite okay, because I have the Poisoner in here, which is a quite a nice card. I think I'll pick it. And I mean, the Glint Sleeve Artisan isn't that bad either, but I think the 2-drop here is the better pick. I'm not gonna pick any of these other color cards. And here we have a Self-Assembler Ballista Charger, but I just don't like this 5-drop vehicle. Crew 3. It's too much. It requires too much power to crew, so I'm not gonna pick that. I think I'm gonna pick the Editail Hawk. I could also pick the Malfunction, actually. I have only one white card. I don't have any other white card, so actually Yeah, I think I should pick the blue card here instead, because this is a quite nice removal spell. And well, I mean, here we don't have any interesting blue card, but we do have a Druid of the Cowl and I guess Wild Wanderer, both of which are good cards. But I do have the Countless Gears Renegade here as well. So if I want to stick to black white, I might want to pick this, but yeah, okay, let's pick this. I mean, I pass a couple of very decent green cards in there, but I'm not sure what's gonna be the pick in here, because we have this Hinterland Drake, a very nice 3-drop for a blue for a deck that plays blue, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna end up playing blue here, so maybe I take the ace in here. It's a decent 2-drop, nothing too exciting, but I maybe pick some vehicle here that I can use this to kind of crew them, and then that vehicle will have a first strike, so maybe it's somehow useful at some point. I'm not so sure. Here we have two options: the impeccable timing versus live fast. Three white cards, two black cards. Okay, so I'm not kind of. Well, I guess I took the impeccable timing in there. I think I would have picked that anyway, but maybe I should have kind of paid more attention to the timer in here. But I think I would have picked this thing anyway, so it's not such a big deal. Here it's the decision between these two cards. Don't have any expensive cards here yet, so I think I'll take the 5-drop. Yep, and well, these are just black pad cards, so I'll take the green sideboard card in case I end up playing green, and I'll take now the conviction here because it seems like I'm gonna play white anyway. Out of these, I think I like the crew with two cards, and this is just unplayable. So Metalwork Colossus, so 11 mana, 10/10, and this gets cheaper. For each artifact you control, assuming the artifacts are not tokens that have no mana cost. Well, I have only a couple of artifacts here in the deck so far, so I'm not that excited about this rare right now. I mean, it's gonna be the revoke privileges. Most likely I'm gonna play white, so this is a very nice removal spell which I'm gonna play here, so let's pick it. And here we have several good cards I want to pick. Another revoke privileges, we also Vengeful Rebel, and then of course this essence extraction. It's gonna be one of those three, but just got this malfunction here. Tough decision. Maybe it's just gonna be the revoke privileges. I think this can get rid of anything, and I guess I'm not locked into black quite yet, so I can just pick the white card here, and maybe if some other color would be very open, I would pick. I mean, for example, the Welding Sparks is in here. It's a pick three, but because I have the Restoration Gearsmith, which is a black-white card, and I have two black cards in here, I think I'm gonna pick this instead. Yeah. And I hope that I'm gonna get some, well, I mean, decent white and black cards. But of course, so far I have only three black cards in the deck, so I mean, I guess the Implement of Malice is also a black card, so anyway. Yeah, we don't have really anything actually There is the Dithril Hawk, but I'm not sure if it's a very good card in this kind of deck. So Self-Assembler, Subtle Strike. I mean, I guess it could be this one. Okay, I'll take the black trick because I don't think this white two drop is very good in this deck. So yeah, it was a weak pack. I might end up cutting this Subtle Strike anyway. Here we have more reasonable cards. I have already one Impeccable Timing, so I'm not gonna pick that. But either of these uncommons is quite decent, I think. And 2/1 and 2/1/1s, or I guess 4/3, which is not that amazing, but the better mode in here is to get the token, so I think I'll take it. But the artifact wasn't that bad either. Here we have a kind of a Foundry Screecher versus a decent sideboard card. I think I'll take the Fragmentize. It's a very nice sideboard card. Here we have a Ally Mechanic. No, Aviary Mechanic. Well, 2 mana, 2/2. Yeah, I guess it's the best pick out of these choices. I'm maybe playing black white, so none of the other cards are very interesting to me. Here it's the decision between the Countless Gates Renegade versus Foundry Screecher. And I think I'll take the Foundry Screecher instead here. A bad pack doesn't really have anything I wanna have in this deck. Crew 3 is just such a large number that I don't think I'm interested in this crusher here. I already have a conviction. I'll just take the uncommon here. Here we have, I think it's gonna be the Morphist Squad, and it's not even a tough decision because there wasn't really much other cards in there that I could have picked. And here it's gonna be the Leaf Fast, the only reasonable card to pick. And I know I'm gonna pick the Dithril Hawk, although I'm not so sure if I'm gonna play that thing. And there's just something unplayable. Okay, so another Restoration Gearsmith. Well, versus pretty much nothing interesting, so certainly worth picking here. Another Long Tusk Cup. Of course, I'm not gonna play green gear, so not gonna pick this, but I think I opened this card too in my first pack in the draft, so if I for some reason I would have picked that, it would be a nice gift to get another one of those. How about this? Yeah, this is just bad. No thanks. Okay, I'll take the flyer here. I mean, I could have picked a two drop, but I think I will have enough two drops here anyway, so I didn't really feel like I need to pick the two drop. If the flyer in here is, it's okay. Okay, Revoke Privileges number 3 is definitely the pick here. I mean, there is Aether Poisoner, which I would like to pick, but it's not as it's not good enough to pick over the Revoke Privileges, so I'll pick that. Here we have Marionette the Master. It's a six drop, but it really doesn't do much. I mean, If you choose to make the tokens, this is just a 1-3, so the secondary ability of this card does kind of nothing. If you choose to get the plus 1 counters, this is gonna be a 4-6, 4-6. And then you have to have a lot of other cards to... Yeah, I mean, it's just gonna be the mechanic here, I think. I mean, that rare is... I don't think it's very good. And how many artificers I have? 9. Well, that's a lot. What are the 9? Nine artificers. Is most of them in the sideboard? No. I don't even know what I picked. I was wasting my time checking out the options. What did I pick there? I actually don't know. Oh, I took this. there was something for my deck. I mean, I just... Yeah, okay, I'll take the revoke privileges here, but I mean... I just lost the card in there because I just didn't realize I was running out of time. Okay. So here we have Fenholler, not good enough. Editorial Hawk, Prophetic Prism. None of this is particularly interesting, so maybe I'll just take the flyer in here. And let's, okay, pick it. Let's take the third Restoration Gearsmith. I mean, that's great, but let's take the Salvager in here. And here we take the yet another Renegade, I guess. This Aether Poisoner came back. What happened? Okay, well, take the implement, construct, hauler. Okay, well, I mean, I missed something. I mean, I was stuck in that one pack where I think I had something better than this hazardous conditions, which I was kind of, well, I auto picked this because I ran out of time, so well, not so sure what was in that pack, but well, I sorry about that. I mean, this wasn't really an optimal way to play these things, but well, I mean, it is what it is. I try to still win the draft, so I think I got a couple of very nice cards because I have three of these restoration gearsmiths here, and they should be quite nice. So it's gonna be a black-white deck. So let's first see the sideboard here for black and white cards and fragmentize. I think I have one Editorial Hawk here. I might end up cutting that too. But yeah, none of these sideboard cards are worth putting it to the main deck. So that means that these are my cards in the deck right now. So 32. I have a lot of easy cuts here, I think. The Hawk can be cut. One of these implement of Malices can be cut. Eager Construct can be cut. Salvager can be cut. Maybe the Foundry's creature can be cut because I don't have that many artifacts. And the Fenholler can be cut. I still need to cut 3 cards and they have to be 2 drops because I have so many 2 drops. Conviction is 1. And Gearsmith Ace is fine, but I have no vehicles in here. So I'm gonna cut that one too. And I guess the worst card out of these is... I think it's gonna be the Implement of Malice or the Sabaldo Strike, but I think... I think I'm gonna cut the Sabaldo Strike here. So I will have 15 creatures, 8 non-creatures. Yeah, I think it's fine. And most of the cards are gonna be white. I have one white double caster. So I think it's gonna be 9-8. So that I will have 9 blades in here. Fifteen creatures, 8 non-creatures, a lot of 2-drops, not really that many 3-drops, well, except for the revoke privileges that I have 4 of, top the arrest, so maybe I will just end up being casting these on opponents 2-drops just for curve reasons, and then I have a couple of decent 4-drops in here. So, okay, let's go with this. I think it's a keep because I have the implement that will draw me another card here. Of course, I will need 2 more lands in here, but if I do get them, I think this is a decent hand. And now we get the poisoner here, which I play rather than the malice, implement of malice here, so. Get the token here now. They will trade, so that's okay, and I will play this implement. So if I don't draw land on the next turn, maybe this activation of this ability. Well, I drew the land, so I don't think I'm gonna Thunder Arrest this guy's gift, so maybe I'll just do this. Okay, another land, that's good. They just got a green card in there, okay. They just missed the land drops there, so it's pretty easy for me now to just play these, make some tokens. Okay, so I'm gonna just Thunder Arrested. They're gonna activate this thing to have a 2-3 blocker and a counter attack. Well, I guess I'm gonna well, I don't have any attacks, so I guess I'm just gonna play this squad. And let's make another 1/1. This creates mana. Crew 3. Well, 5-5. Yeah, they can crew that thing. Well, I guess I have to revoke the privileges from this guy. This has many, so I will attack with this. Bloomera. So this thing cannot... Okay, so they are gonna get 2-1 on flyers. What does this mean? This has many, so they have to block it with two guys. I could attack with everyone. I mean, this is... No, I can't. They're gonna get a 2-3 there. So I only can attack with the 3-1 here, actually. Okay, let's do that then. Okay, I'm gonna kill the equipment here. And then I'm gonna return something here, which I think has to be the squad. Okay, so they got some good stuff, but they are this thing got tapped. So if I just revoke privileges in here, I can make some attacks. So attack with these two. Got rid of a guy of mine, I can play the renegade here. First striker, and this costs 3 to crew. Okay. Okay, then. Six mana. Okay, I'll do this. So now they have one blocker. Versus my quite a few attackers. So if they, I mean, they're gonna block their restoration gear smith and I will deal 7 damage. I think it's worth it. the opponents scry to the top, I will scry to the bottom here, so they have like two blockers, I mean four blockers actually. And they can of course screw this one, which will cost them, they will have to tap two of these guys. I can get the scrounger back easily, so I don't mind if they block this. If they block the renegade and the scrounger, I still will deal 4 damage in here. So yeah, I'm just gonna attack with all. Actually 5 damage, yeah. No, no, 4, because they have this one flyer. Okay, they can tap 2 guys to block one of them. They still take a lot of damage here. 7 damage, in fact. Unless they have something. Okay, that's fine. And I'm at 19, so there's no... I don't think I'm in a big trouble here. They have 3 life, so I think I'm gonna play the squad so that I'm gonna make the 1-1 token, because the 3-1 will be lethal anyway. So let's do it like this. Building sparks. Okay, fine. That's okay, but I wonder why they... Okay, well, they took some damage and then used the building sparks. They still have only 1, 2, 3 blockers. Yeah, that's fine. 4 blockers. And I have 6 attackers. So what does this mean? 1, 2, 3, 4 blockers. They can't, if they want to activate this, they will have to tap at least 1 guy. So basically it is gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4 blockers. If I attack with everyone, they're gonna block 1, 2, 3, 4. They're gonna actually they can drop to 1 health. That's actually not so great, but I guess I can get the scrounger back. So yeah, it's gonna be a decent idea. Let's attack a bit all, because they have to block the scrounger, and I will be getting it back. So it's a kind of I'm not gonna even lose this scrounger. Yeah. Two mana to get that bottom back, so let's do it like this. Hunter weak. Okay then. So they have 1, 2, 3 blockers, so they have exactly the amount of blockers they need to survive. Because any attacker that I can get is gonna be lethal, but of course they do have what? Yeah. So I have 3 attackers, they have 3 blockers, so I can't win here right now unless I draw a removal spell. Which I did not. That's a pretty sad thing, because if I attack with these, they can just block with the 5-5. 1, 2, 3 blockers. So yeah, I don't have a lethal attack. So, okay. Can't attack, so let's pass. Of course, this means that I'm probably just losing here now, because they have 4 cards in here. They will be able to get more blockers in there, and at some point they will be just be able to start attacking. week, okay. Okay, they will attack with something. No blocks, of course, I can take the 5, so that means that if I had drawn a removal, I actually would have won the game, because they took a big risk in there, assuming they don't have anything with their 100 mana here. But they have this one to block with, they have this one to block with. So yeah, okay. Can't attack. Well, they at least used all the mana, so again, if they attack with even, I mean, if they attack with just one creature, they are safe against removal. So yeah, they did that, so I have no chance anymore, because the Gearsmith says that I can return on another Gearsmith. Can't attack here. 5-4 have like 14 damage. I need to block. This doesn't have a trample. This has trample. Okay. That's it. So now I have 5 attackers, and they need to have 5 blockers for my guys. So 1, 2, 3, 4 currently. Well, I'm guessing they have something in here. But maybe I draw some removal perhaps or something. So they have 6 mana and 2 cards. I'm sure they have something, because yet another hunter week. So they have like 3 hunter weeks. Okay. My Gearsmith died. And what kind of an attack are they gonna have in here? I have 9 life, so they can't attack. They grew this thing. What? Okay, so they tapped. Interesting. So they have 2 mana left and 1 card, and they are attacking 7, 12, okay, 17 damage, so I have to block a lot of these guys. One of them has trample. This thing has trample, okay. This can't be blocked with a small guy. So basically, if I block the 5-5 and with this poisoner, and then I block this 5-5 with a 3-3, then I will take 7 damage. What's it? What's this? So if I do it like this and this. No, I actually, yeah, no, not this, but this. So this will mean 7 damage. And then I have a lethal attack with 2 of my guys, so 1 blocker of removal won't be enough. Do they have like a boost spell? So if I decide to block also this 2-2. And they have a blocker, then I can't have a lethal damage. So if they have boost spell, if they have a boost spell, I will lose. So I think I'll just take the gamble here. And they did. So in fact, if I had blocked this 2-2, no, I would have still lost, I think. No, would I have? So if I would have blocked this one, they would have boosted this one. Yeah, I actually wouldn't have died. But I think it was more likely that they have a blocker. I don't know. I mean, it was pretty close. I think it was more likely that they have a 2-mana blocker than that I have than that they have a 2-mana boost spell, because if I had blocked this thing with the 1-1, which was the only thing I can use to block, and then they play any creature, then this won't be lethal unless I draw a removal spell, and then I will lose the next turn. So I think it was more likely that they have a creature than that they have a boost spell. So the decision, I think it was correct after all. But so a lot of Hunter weeks, and then we have not so sure. White and black. So fragmentized. Does that have any? They have a cultivator's caravan, and they have a sky skiff. This cobra, world fast money for eco construct. I guess there are enough targets for the fragmentize. And I will cut like a perhaps a aviary mechanic here, and then I'm gonna choose to I'm not so sure. Fin hauler, shovel to strike. Not so sure. I'll just play like this, and let's see if there's some. If I win this game, I can make some further changes to the deck. Okay, fine hand. So opponent is deciding whether they're gonna mulligan or not. They did not. Okay. So I can block this with the Death Toucher, and before the blocks, they can choose to make this a 4-3 trample. I don't mind. Let's do it. I can take 3 damage here. They're gonna lose this thing anyway. And then they have a Traveling Rhino, and I have a lot. I've drawn a lot of land here, so. Still think that I'm gonna just attack with this, make the token with my 2 energy, and then I can play the implement, and then of course I can use the impeccable timing in response to this thing attacking. I hope they don't have any other boost spell. They did not. Okay, that's fine. No blockers so far. We can take the poisoner back. Oh, this thing only costs... Okay, I'll just attack with everything first. And maybe I'll just do this thing now. And I will rather take the implement back than the poisoner. No place so far. What does that mean? Is there some flash thing here for green, red, or blue, I guess? I don't think so. I'll just attack with everything. Let's see what happens. Yeah, that's fine. They kill the 3-3 and take 3 damage. Okay, so 2 cards in hand. I think I'll still take just play the Mastodon rather than the Implement of Malice. Alright then, so they have 2 cards still, so no reason to perhaps play the Implementer right now, so I'll just attack with everything. I don't need the Vigilance for the Mastodon. Okay, so they're just having nothing, I guess. Which means that I'm gonna play the Malphist Squad. Make a 1-1 thing, and I'll play the Implement here as well. So they are probably just having a lot of lands in the hand, so I won that game. What is going to be my sideboarding decision here? I think it's going to be like... Yeah, I don't think I need any changes. I mean, I was thinking about the Fenhauler, but I don't think it's that great after all. I have so few artifacts, it's gonna cost like a 6 mana most of the time, so it's maybe not worth it. Let's just do it like this. So this hand is quite good. I'm gonna keep it. I have a 2-drop and 3-drop. I mean, sort of a 3-drop. And well, I guess I can kill that with the fragmentize, but I'm not sure I want to do that. I guess I'm gonna just well, I don't need the swamp here. Definitely a useful scry there. Already have 3 swamps here, so I'm just gonna play the 2-drop and I will trade it. I think I will have a target for the fragmentize later. Okay, so I think I'm just gonna revoke privileges on that. Oh, they didn't want to attack with 2-2. Interesting. Well, I'm gonna attack here. If they block with a 2-3, I'm gonna just use the impeccable timing. They did not, so I'm gonna revoke the privileges. I think I'm fine with the race here. So let's attack 2. And then I can... I can do a couple of things. Do I want an impeccable timing in this thing? Maybe I do. So let's just do the mana efficient thing here. Okay, they get to draw some cards. One on top. But they have a lot of cards in here, so... But then again, I do have a draw 2 in here as well. Oh, that was nasty. So they were able to kill both of my guys. I still kill this, of course, to just to use the mana efficiently. But I would have liked to get the, you know, the 1/1s there, because especially because I have this live fast, so I could have made another one of those 1/1s at some point. But well, I'll take this thing and I will make a token here. Five cards versus my, well, I mean 4 cards versus my 4, so it's pretty even situation. Anyone could win here. Tiger in here, can't do anything to that quite yet. So I'm just gonna attack for 2. Yeah, I should have maybe played this first, but whatever. Oh, no land. Well, that's bad. That's very bad. I mean, these are good cards, but I would have rather have to the land to play this implement, perhaps. So, now I'm at 10 here. Yeah, I cannot at least revoke the privileges there. That's not gonna do anything itself. But now that is... Well, it doesn't draw any card, but that does mean that this Sky Skiff is going to be able to block my 2/1 flyer here, so I can't attack. This is gonna get +2/+2 because they do have still energy left, so I have to revoke the privileges. Then again, I do have the fragmentize, so I think I'm gonna just yeah. Let's do it like this. Revoke the privileges from this guy. They have a 3/3 guy. So I can play other the implement of malice. It does nothing here, so I will play fragmentize. Targeting the skiff here. And maybe I will attack 2 and take 3. Yeah, I will do that. I can take 3 here. I have a lot of jump blockers for this 3/3 if I want to have those. And of course I will have this 4/5 coming up too. So they did not do anything so far. Well, I will attack with each guy and then I will play the this thing. Make some tokens. Play the implement. Okay, they can do that. Do wanna... If they attack, I will double block, of course. Okay, they are not gonna attack then. That's good. They have one card in hand. I'm suspecting it's gonna be a land. So, I can either play the Restoration Gearsmith and return the Death Toucher, which I can play, or I can just make them discard and then I play the Mastodon, which is gonna block most of their team. So, okay, that makes me perhaps more sense. It's gonna be a land most likely. Okay, yeah, it was actually a Hunter weak, So that was pretty great, I think. And I still can, because I drew a land, I can play the Chiasmate into Death Touch guy anyway. Okay, so I'm gonna attack for 2 here. And I'm gonna actually play the Death Touch guy, because neither of these have Trample, right? Yeah. It's the safest way to do like this. I could have taken something more like impactful, but I just want to have the kind of blockers. Okay, this will get Trample, which means that I can... I block with this poisoner. I think I'm gonna just do it like this, yeah. I'll take only 1 Trample damage there. That's fine. They're gonna scry to top bottom, and I will scry to, well, bottom as well. And flyer and 1/1. This doesn't have. Yeah, I think I'm gonna attack for 3 here. They probably are gonna. I mean, they are gonna block with the construct. So yeah, maybe it's a bad idea. Yeah, let's just attack with the 2 powder guy. Yeah. They conceded. Interesting. I mean, I guess they drew a land there, but I wasn't gonna win on the next turn. If they had a land there, I could have attacked him to 3, I think. I mean, I could have attacked with like everything. I don't know. Anyway, that was it. Let's play more. The hand is 5 lands, 3 and 5 drops. Oh, okay, I think I have to mulligan this. This hand just doesn't do anything, so I will hope to get a better 6 card hand, and I think this is better. I'm gonna lose the double casters in my deck are white or black. Don't remember quite yet. So it's gonna be... I don't remember. Maybe I'll just... Yeah, well, I will lose the white here, but I actually don't remember about the double caster in my deck. Okay. Well, at least I have the double white here anyway, so that's fine. Yeah, I'm gonna block this 2/1 if they're gonna attack. Because I have another one of these poisoners in here. Yeah, I can do this. I'll block this 1/2. Maybe not. Or maybe I will. I mean, the 1/1 isn't gonna do anything, so yeah, I'm gonna block it. They weren't interested in attacking, so I'll just have the menace guy, but do I wanna have a 3/1 menace or 4/2 menace? Maybe it's gonna be the 3/1, yeah. Okay, so they're gonna have something there for sure. Yeah, block this, and I guess block this. Okay, there was nothing. Okay then, that's fine. Although, well, I'm not gonna use my removal now. I mean, I can use the, I will use the impeccable timing against this pillar bug. But let's see. I guess I have to just use the revoke privileges on this just to get something going on here. No, it's a top deck war here. Whoever draws better cards will win. This is crew one, yeah. Okay, I drew a land, so basically I've lost the game now because, well, I haven't lost the game here, but it's because they can attack for 5 now and then they can attack for 6 and I cannot attack only for 1, so I would really need to draw something very, very good in here. But I mean, I guess I have some outs in here. For example, the thing, I have 3 of those things that have returned creatures or artifacts from the graveyard to my hand, so let's see. I can return this Death Toucher and still be alive, but of course I'm having now. Oh, that's bad, that's very bad. They had they have just more business than I do have. Yeah, with the land in here, I will just concede because there's no way I'm gonna win this game. How about do I want to have a fragment? I think I might want to Cobra, Pillar Bug. This is a 4-cost card, so I can kill all of those with the fragmentize. So I will have a fragmentize in there for sure. How about Subtle Strike doesn't do much. I mean, they have two two ones, so maybe I can consider it. The other cards are not that interesting. And what am I going to cut? Maybe the Aviary Mechanics. Yeah, let's do it like this. Good hand, and I have a turn to Scrouncher, definitely amazing. No, amazing, definitely strong start here. Okay, so yeah, I don't mind trading here. I will just play the leaf fast here anyway. I will get that thing back at a later point anyway, or I can just gearsmith it back. Okay, well, there was no land here so far. That was unfortunate, but let's see what they're gonna play. Okay, they're gonna get, well, man, that is sad. They're gonna get back this thing, so maybe I'll just use my mana efficient and I will use the revoke here, because they now they won't be able to block with this. And this won't be returned, but I would have rather had land there. Well, now I did have it, so think it. Well, it's not gonna be. I don't have double white, so I can only play this 3/3, I think. So We'll take this scrounger here. Yeah. Yeah, okay, they can... do I wanna just kill them right away? Or attack for 3? I'll just block it. And here we get a flyer and a 1-1. Server token. I will block the 2-1 here. And they will have a pillar bug. I can thopter. I mean, I can fragmentize that at some point. Yeah, I can do it right away. I guess I should have attacked first, because now they can just use the... Well, they didn't use the designs quite yet, so maybe it's not such a big deal. Not a pillar bug, no big deal there. Yeah. I will choose the tokens, of course, because they have this thing active right now. So I don't have the mana for the impeccable timing right now, but I will have it. They attack with this and gain 2 life. It's fine. Oh, they did not. And I drew it another... Well, I have a lot of 4 removal in my 4-card hand, so how do I use it? I think I'm gonna use it so that... I'm gonna revoke the privileges on this 2-3. Then I'm gonna attack with everything. And use the impeccable timing on the pillar bug. Return the pioneer, or I'm gonna return the gearsmith, of course. So let's attack with everything and do like this. Return the gearsmith. I do have 3 of these in my deck, so that's pretty strong. So I have these things in here. Does that mean, well, I have the fragmentize already in my deck. Is there a reason to choose something else in my deck to be played? Finhaller. I don't have that many artifacts here, so I don't think it's that... It doesn't make that much sense. Creatures 13. So... yeah, I think it's fine the way it is. Let's just play it like this. Well, starting hand is definitely again good. I can play the scrounger turn 2 and Well, let's see. Oh, that is great. I mean, I can't revoke the privileges if they get to remove the countless gears renegade, but I'm definitely playing this right now to block this. If they remove this and then this will be a bigger guy, then I will just okay, they do that. So what do I do here? I mean, I can block it and they will make it a 3-3. Yeah, I'll just revoke the bridge. They will get to 5 energy and then I will... I wonder why didn't they... deal additional damage here. But well, I mean, they didn't, so whatever. I will revoke the privileges from the guy. And I will be blocking the sage in there. No reason to be racing. So here we have Scrouncher and the Poisoner. And I will take the 2 damage from this thing if they attack. Okay, they will it's a 3-3. Okay, they're gonna even do that. Well, I can't block it now, so well, the implement will get rid of their last card in their hand, and then I hope I actually can stabilize from there. But they will be dealing 5 to me on the next turn, but it's not gonna kill me quite yet. So yeah. Is it a land or a decent spell? It was... well, I mean... a spell, but not a particularly good one. Anyway, and I just drew a line, but I can still win because the Restoration Gearsmith is gonna return and they play the land. Why did they play it rather than keep it in the hand? Well, no matter. This can't block, so I'm gonna attack with it anyway. And then I will have 6 mana available and I can use it just to play the Gearsmith and get the Poisoner back. Alright, that sounds good. So I can block the 3-3 or... I don't actually want to block it because they get to draw a card if it dies. So I'm actually gonna take the 3 damage and play the revoke privileges unless they have something very big here. Well, they did, so I'm gonna revoke the privileges. From that guy. This means that. They'll take 6 and maybe I'll play the 2-2. Yeah, I'll take the 2-2, yeah. I mean, there's not such a big chance to get the 1-1 out of this revolt ability. So do I take I let them draw the card now. I will prevent 3 damage. So they're looking at their graveyard, so they have something that he can use to return cards from the graveyard. So that's, yeah, for to just find is gonna be bad. They're gonna, that's so much value for them, because they can. And I drew just land, so that's like a, the worst possible outcome for me. So I'm just gonna attack with the scrounger. No reason to attack with the gearsmith here. So yeah. They will get this one too. They can reach, well, there's no artifact in the graveyard right now, so I'll just take the three here. I mean, no reason to trade so far. That's a 2-3, of course, because of this. And that gearsmith is definitely pretty amazing, so I think I'm gonna attack with both of these three power guys. So if they don't block, they're gonna drop to three. If they block, well, it's all the better for me. So I'm gonna play the 3-3 and return the. This doesn't do anything. This I could actually get rid of their card in the hand, unless it's some kind of instant speed spell that they're gonna use to. Well. Get rid of my blocker there. Interesting, in fact. I could just take the poisoner too. So, I can take this and make them discard. I have two blockers for their guys. None of these are later by themselves. Well, I think it's just a safer way to play the poisoner anyway, I think. Or is it that? Is it so? I mean, hard decision. I think I'll take the Death Toucher anyway, but I don't think it was an easy decision. Okay, that's fine. They have four blockers, so they can't really attack with anyone if they don't have a way to remove my guys. So, so they will have four blockers, so I don't have a lethal if they leave everyone as a blocker. And if they have like a land in hand, they can't really attack. I mean, I guess they can attack with the filigree familiar, but I'm pretty sure I just take the damage, maybe. Do I suspect that the card in the hand is a land or a, well, like a boost spell? Hard to say. They are actually thinking here as well, so it's not something too trivial, because if they had like a land in hand, that actually is not much of a, there's no reason for them to attack. I mean, I guess they could consider if they want to attack with their filigree familiar, and if I block, they get to draw another card. But if they attack with the filigree familiar, I don't think I'm gonna block that. I don't want to give the card to them. I would kind of like to force them to have the plus one, minus one, or any kind of boot spell, basically, Supple Strike or anything else that gives the creature more power. So they're actually running out of their timeouts here now, so if they don't do anything, they're gonna just pass the turn to me right now. It seems to be the case. Okay. And I just drew a land here, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 attackers, so my attacks won't be lethal in here. But I'm gonna, of course, attack with the Scrounger because that's not gonna be able to block. But what else am I gonna use to attack with? I mean, I passed the priority here because I was moving to my attackers, so the opponent did time out last turn. Okay, I mean, now they're here, so they're not gonna time out. If I attack with two guys, because they're gonna have to block any three power guy I throw in their way. But problem is that if I attack with like a Restoration Gearsmith and a scrap heap Scrounger, they're gonna block with the familiar and the workshop assistant, and they're gonna get to draw a card, and they're gonna get this familiar back. So it's not optimal at all. If I attack with all the three power guys, they're gonna have to block with this and this and one of the other guys too. This is not such an easy decision. I could just attack with this and they will block with their familiar. They will draw a card and I will have blockers for their guys. Although they have energy for this. This will be a 3-4, but I will attack it with a poisoner. I will block it with a poisoner. So, but if I attack with all these three, what does that mean? They can double block. I have two blockers in here. They will block with this thing. I will have still this and this, and this is gonna block something, I think. So maybe I'll just do this. I mean, they will get a sick amount of. I mean, I can attack with only one this Scrounger, or I can attack with all these three. It's tough decision. I mean, if I attack with this, they'll block with the familiar. If I attack with all these three, they will block the Scrounger or some of these with the familiar, and then they will have to block with if I attack with everything, wait a minute, that isn't gonna be a good attack. No, they can just take the 1-1. They can block the 2-2 with this and block this. Okay, I'll just do this. There's no time here. I'm gonna run out of time otherwise. Too bad I drew the land here, because if I had drawn a spell here, the decision would have been a lot easier. But I don't think. They will have to block every one of these, but they will draw a card from this, and well, they will have only one guy here, because they will have to block everything here, so they will just double block the assist now. Well, I mean, well, it's not such an easy decision for them either, I think. Okay, that's fine. So that means that they'll return the familiar, of course. I think I'm gonna have to kill the rhino here instead of the chief of the foundry. Yeah, that's fine. I do have this scrap heap Scrounger to return, but problem is that they can play this familiar again, gain 2 life, and I just drew a land here. Maybe I should have played the land, but they have stabilized the game, and I need some help from my deck. Okay, that's gonna gain them even more life, and I'll just return this thing and exile this renegade here. I can't even attack with it now because. Yeah, I mean, maybe I should have actually Well, this chapter arrest is of course gonna be great here. But I think I should have double... I mean, I had the choice to kill this rhino or this chief of the foundry, I think. I think I should have chosen the chief instead, but now that I drew the chapter arrest, it's maybe quite fine after all. So, what is gonna be my attack in here? I'll just attack with the scrounger and see what they do. Yeah, that's fine. It's gonna die now. They get 3 life, which is sad, but it's a good one. Good decision. I mean, for me it's good because now I can get rid of the chief of the foundry, which will be getting rid of the pillar bug. And I will get to return this scrounger here anyway. And now it's a top deck war. Well, that's a good one. It has trample, right? Yeah, okay, that's bad for me. I need to draw something good. Well, I have to block this with the 2/2, I think. Yeah, they will draw a card. I mean, yeah, they had nasty amount of synergy there, but I mean, I can still win if they draw like a, if they have a land in hand and draw another land and then I draw. Well, scratch that. If I still draw, I have like 4 of these revoke privileges, so maybe I still have some kind of chance in here, but... Oops. But it's a low chance. Let's see if I can get the revoke privileges here. Land. Well. Can't attack. So if they have a land in here, well, let's see. Okay. Oh man, why did... well, this is gonna have trample, discount block, 5/5, yeah, it's gonna be enough. I mean, I drew too many lands here. They had vehicles, which are not very good when they have only one creature there, but when I draw only lands there, it's gonna... I didn't, of course. I wasn't able to stabilize the situation. So let's try to win the match number 3 then. Play first, and the hand is, I think it's a keepable, it's only a, it's a 5 land hand, but I have 2 playable spells in here, all the colors I need, and the spells are gonna be happening early. Of course, it's not optimal that I drew a land right away here, but let's hope to draw at least some non-lands here. That's actually pretty perfect draw here. Let's see if they don't have a removal here, so I get to have a 1/1, and then we'll draw 2 cards, and perhaps next turn I can get even another 1/1 because I get 2 energy from this. Oh man, that is not optimal. So can't attack, block or crew vehicles, but can use activated abilities. That's the problem here. I guess I'm just gonna then attack with this guy, make a token. They are gonna block with the flyer, okay. I was kind of planning to return the guy and replay it to get even more energy, but that did not work out, so... Let's just play this one and not return anything. I mean, it was pretty obvious that they're gonna block with the flyer there. This is gonna be a double strike thing, so... Just play the 5-5 and I can revoke the privileges on the next turn. Because I can't, obviously I can't attack with the 2-2 and they have a 2-2 double striker. Okay, that's what they had. Main deck Gremlin. Main deck Gremlin, they can use it to kill the Mastodon. Right then. Well, I guess they're gonna deal 6 to me, and then I'm gonna revoke the privileges. I could jump one. I mean, I guess I could gain here 6 life to just jump block. Maybe it makes sense. Here we have. I guess I just have to do it like this. I'm not gonna attack because I'd rather trade with the PNLR than race here. Yeah, sure, you have a big guy there, and I hope I draw something else than a land. Well, that is a good one. If I make this a 4-2, I can just block this guy. Okay, let's do that. So they have something here. Well, I'm just gonna... I mean, if they have double strike, this gonna be horrible, but I will double block this just in case, because at least I get rid of the PNLR if they have a double strike there. But problem is that they are actually gonna be able to... Okay, well, that's not so bad, I think. They're gonna block that. Why did they block that? That didn't make any sense. I mean, no sense whatsoever. They were at 19 life. I'm happy they did that. That was the best trade in the history of trades. Well, maybe not that good, but definitely a decent one. Yeah, okay, I can do that. That dies. I'll get this back and I'll just get rid of the mechanic, I guess. Fenhauler, that's a good one. May return at permanent. Okay, there's no attack, but I can return this thing and play it again to get a 1-1. And this can't be blocked by artifact creatures, so I have to take the 5 damage here. Unless I want to jump block, but I'm not gonna want to jump block. This I can't block with anything. Except the Scrounger, of course. So, Yeah, I need to draw something good here. And I did draw something good here. But I can't attack because they have a 4-4 blocker and I can't get through that quite yet. But it was good to get rid of the Fenhalle. They can get rid of some of my... Wait a minute, they have like a... several Runos Kremlin's main deck. That's not really what they want to do. I can return that easily, so... Okay. That happened. Well, okay, I'm gonna return this and I will get rid of this Renegade here. Interesting. The Gearsmith is gonna return me the Mastodon or the Molfist squad. I think it's gonna be them. Okay, I have... Alright, so I have 8 mana, so I'm gonna get the 4 drop because I have mana to cast it right away. It's gonna be a 4-2 menace. Flying lifelink. And they can get a counter. Okay, it's 3-3 flying lifelink. That's nasty if I can't draw any answer to that. Do they have a removal for my 4-2? That would be very nasty actually. Okay, well, I can get rid of their whatever card is in their hand. Although, do I want to do that? I mean, it's... Well, I guess I do it pre-combat. Yeah. Land, not good. They had hijack. Well, that could have been very relevant, so... But I'm still losing this game because they have this 3-3 flyer lifelink, so... Not optimal. I need to find a removal for this thing. I just drew a land here, so not great. Okay, but they got what? Okay, I mean maybe the opponent is not really understanding what they should be doing. I mean they definitely should have just taken the 4 damage and start attacking for 3 in the air. So, they didn't do that. So here is actually interesting choice. They did draw the 3-2 here, which means that if I'm making this at 4-3, it's not gonna be that helpful. But I don't think that 1-1s help me that much either. So I'll just play this as a 4-3 and hope to get some kind of removal for this enraged giant at some point, perhaps. Well, that's good. I mean, I guess it would have been better to have this 1-1 instead, but I'm not gonna whine when I draw this thing, and now I can attack with basically... I mean, I could attack with everything. 2, 4, 7, 10, 14 if they block... 15 actually if they block this 1-1, so I'm gonna attack with everyone. Don't care if they block 4-3 in here. Okay, but I don't think that's enough. No, it's not. I have more than enough attackers in here. Also drew a pretty nice card here, but that's more than enough damage if they block any of my guys. Yeah, sure. So, black-red deck against me and... Let's see. Main deck Gremlins, couple of those. Okay, Rampage, Pianolara, Nolara, 5-4. Lifelink Flyer. I don't think there's much in my sideboard. Fragmentize maybe, but I didn't see really. Yeah, they have no artifacts basically. Or enchantments, so no fragmentize in here. How about the Implement of Malice? How about Sable Strike? Foundry Screecher, Fenhauler. I mean, I guess if they keep these Ruinous Gremlins in the deck, I can play them Subtle Strike to get rid of them before they can get rid of my artifacts, I think. So I will cut one of these Aviary Mechanics, I think, and have a Subtle Strike here. But do I want to have like an Implement of Malice number 2 here? I have 14 creatures in here. They are black red. They have some removal here, so it might be. They have also this hijack, so it might be. Yeah, I think the 2/2 isn't necessarily that great here, so maybe I'll take another Implement of Malice. Not the Fenhauler, no, I don't think. And then I will cut another Aviary Mechanic here. Alright, that's good. Okay, hand is again good. I have had a lot of these scrap heap scrounger starts. So can't blame about not drawing my good rare here. Definitely a best 2-drop available. I mean, I could have played these to get the 1/1, but I can do it later on. It's death butter. I can always attack with this. And get the 1/1. Okay, that's fine because that will be coming back here at some point. So I'll just play the Death Butcher now. I can play the Pioneer and then I can play the Master only if I draw a 5th land. So things seem good here now. Killed that. Well, I mean, that's fine. I can just return the scrounger now. Sure, I'll do that. Okay. I'll get rid of a planes, no big deal. Well, okay, they have several discard things. Well, this is gonna go away, and I think the Renegade is gonna go away too. Then I'm gonna return this, get rid of the Renegade, I think. And then they still have a 1 discard effect in here, so that's interesting. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna just do it like this. Yeah, I can get rid of the Impeccable Timing if they choose to activate their implement. Okay, well, that is fine, but okay, they need a little bit of help from the other cards to get rid of the timing. Yeah, nothing is gonna happen unless they play like, well, ways to gain energy there. Of course, many ways to gain energy there, but let's not attack with the scrounger and play the flyer, and I will take the token instead of making this a 3-2, because they have black red, they have a lot of removal in the deck, I at least assume. Okay, well, I can top the arrest and that if I want to. Yeah. It has lifelink, I don't really like that, so let's get rid of it. Now the opponent has to do something very soon because I have a lot of damage in here. They have no board presence. They have to do something to my creature, so I have some blockers available there. Do I wanna get rid of their one of their hand cards right now? I could play the poison after that. Other option is to just attack with this Scrounger, I think, and then play the Bastion Mastodon. But I think I like this option more. They probably have just a land there to discard, but who knows? Maybe it is a spell. And that was a great draw. Of course, I have three of these, and they didn't get rid of a spell. I mean, a land. They did. Discard this, so what's gonna be there? I think I'm gonna attack with the. I'm just gonna attack with the Pioneer too, because I can return the Pioneer with the Gearsmith. Okay, that does nothing. Interesting. Right. So now that they block the scrap heap Scrounger, I think I'm more interested in playing there. Poisoner and the Scrounger EOT. Okay. Because I have other creatures to remove here. Okay. They attack. For what reason? Why do they attack? I don't get it. I block with the Death Toucher, of course. Why would they attack there? I get rid of the poisoner here. I'll just play the Mastodon. I'll wait if I have a better target for the. I mean, I guess I could have picked this one up, but I couldn't have double spelled anyway, so. Well, they are now losing the game, so that's it. No good blocks for them. Alright, so again, a 2-1. I mean, how many 2-1s I have? I actually haven't kept record, but I think that the majority of my Kaladesh Remastered traditional drafts have been 2-1. Well, which is fine, of course, but I mean, I would have liked to have some maybe more 3-0s there, but I always get to lose one of these matches at least. But then again, 2-1 is so much better than 1-2 or 0-3, so I shouldn't really be that sad about it. So 2-1 is a fine result, so let's be happy about that. And well, there's still a couple of days time to play these drafts before they end, so you will be seeing more of these before they end. So let's see in the next draft. Bye bye.